Okay. How much had to drink tonight?
Two beers.
Okay. I just want to make sure. All right. Because at this point in time, you are going to be under arrest for DUI, okay?
These incidents illustrate encounters with law enforcement officers and individuals suspected of driving under the influence, DUI.
So you haven't had any alcohol to drink tonight?
No, sir.
Okay, there's no resting nystagmus, but your eyes are bouncing a little bit.
Okay, so with that right there, you're under arrest for DUI, okay?
Oh my God, I'm actually killing myself. This is the last straw. No, I'm going to kill myself.
Each incident unfolds uniquely, revealing the challenges faced by officers in assessing and addressing potentially dangerous situations on the road.
What were you drinking?
It's in the car still.
You're under arrest for driving under the influence of an intoxicating liquor and or drug. The New Mexico Implied Consent Act requires that you submit to a breath test to determine the alcohol.
From Erica's nighttime encounter to Gloria's near tragic situation, these narratives shed light on the complexities of enforcing DUI laws and how the cops handled the situation against the perpetrators. Here are some incidents where Pretty Woman got arrested for DUI.
Your refusal to submit to blood or urine testing may be offered as evidence against you at trial.
The incident revolved around a 25-year-old woman named Erica. On the 15th of April, 2023, in Lumpkin Street, Athens-Clarke County, Georgia, a cop assisted Officer Gresham on a traffic stop. According to her, she saw the vehicle operating without headlights and observed that the vehicle failed to maintain the lane. As a result, law enforcement decided to look into the matter seriously. Upon approaching the white vehicle, the police encountered Erica. Due to her skeptical behavior, law enforcement decided to check further and began questioning her. Soon, the officer expressed to her the next line of action with which she agreed to comply.
I pulled into a parking spot on East Plate. Hey! Any reason why you pulled into the parking spot?
Oh, because it's just safest.
Okay, you got your license on you? You know why I pulled you over?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know.
Look in the front. What do you not see?
Oh, my.
Sorry. 5 seconds. I got a 27. You ready? You had anything to drink?
I have, yeah.
How much you done had to drink?
I had a couple beers.
A couple beers? How many is a couple? What size? How big?
Like,
two beers? What bar were you at?
I was at Clark's.
I got you. This your car's in your name? Is
yes.
In your name? Anybody else in the car? Nobody else in the car. You mind turning the car for me? Give me that back. Oh, you good. I see. I can see. Go ahead and step out the car for me. You can turn the car off. You can just leave the keys on the dash. You don't have to roll it up, just step out.
Alright, step back there for me.
Hey, how are you? I'm Officer Hope, the Oscar County Police Department. Where are you headed to tonight?
Headed home.
Where were you at?
I'm 2 minutes from here.
Okay. What were you doing tonight? Where are you going from? Like, where are you coming from?
I was coming from Clark's, like, bar.
Okay.
And I was going to my house.
Okay. How much had to drink tonight?
Two beers?
Mm-hmm. Okay. You mind taking some voluntary field sobriety test to make sure you're okay to drive?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Would you like to put your shoes on, or are you okay without your shoes?
I'm okay without my shoes.
377 Central Signal 1 check. All right.
Law enforcement decided to conduct distinctive procedures on her to overlook her overall condition. Seemingly, her tumble-down mood was visible. Therefore, the officer also increased his focus. Upon further inspection, her deluding nature was badly uncovered.
You're going to follow the tip of my finger with mm-hmm. your eyes, with your eyes only. Do not move your head. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I got it.
Okay.
All right, first of all, take a step away. All right, now put your feet together just like this.
Mm-hmm.
Hands down to your side, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna follow tip of my finger with your eyes only. Do not move your head, do you understand?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Okay, 911 open line, 1025 Barnett Schultz Road.
I think my windows are down. Can you go?
Where's the car?
Right behind yours.
Okay. An open mind with no voice and no response to a DUI. Well, I got a busy take.
Put your hands down to your side for me. Yep. Keep them there, okay? Don't move your head, okay? So, the next test is going to be called the walk-in turn, okay? You can step out here for me. Alright, you'd say this is pretty even. You don't think this is hell, do you?
No.
Okay. No. Yeah, can you turn it off? Alright, so face me. Alright, what I want you to do is you're going to take your left foot and put it in front of your right foot. So take your left foot, put it on the line. Put that as an imaginary line there. Take your left foot, put it on the line. Take your right foot, put it in front of your left foot, heel to toe, just like that. All right, stand just like that, okay? You're gonna maintain that position until I tell you to do otherwise, so you understand. Okay. All right, so what you're gonna do, when I tell you to do so, you'll take 9 heel to toe steps. Once you hit that 9th step, you're gonna leave your lead foot planted. And you're going to turn around, taking a series of small steps. Then you will return, taking another 9 heel-to-toe steps. I will demonstrate for you just like this.
1, 2, 3. Leave that lead foot planted. Once you get to
the 9, when you're going to leave that foot, lead foot planted, you're going to take a series of small steps around that lead foot, just like this. And then you will return, taking another 9 heel-to-toe steps. 1, 2, 3, all the way to 9. Okay, you understand that? Okay. All right. So go ahead and get in that position I told you to get into.
39 central, I'm gonna be primary on that.
All right, so once you start, do not stop. Make sure you keep your hands down to your side. Make sure you look down at your feet and make sure you count out loud. You understand? Go ahead.
1, 2, 3. 14, go ahead.
All right, now the next test you're gonna do, it's called the one leg stand, okay? So you're gonna take each foot, it doesn't matter which one, okay? You're gonna pick one, and you're gonna hold it approximately 6 inches off the ground. You're gonna look down, while looking down at your foot, you're gonna count 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, so on and so forth until I tell you to stop.
Okay.
You understand that? All right, I'll let you know when to begin. All right, so I'll let you know when to begin. So like I said, to make sure you keep both legs straight, keep your hands down to your side. Make sure you look down at your feet. Make sure you count out loud. And if you put your foot down, you can pick it back up and just continue where you left off, okay? You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, 1 second. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
You can start.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
You can stop.
Sorry, can you give me a picture of Quantrell Gilbert?
What's your name, sweet? What's your name?
Erica.
Erica? All right.
Yes, my name on.
So be honest with me, how much you had to drink tonight?
3 beers.
3 beers. Just 3 beers.
3.
You sure?
Yeah.
You sure?
Be more.
Okay, how about approximately how much?
I don't know.
It's on there.
Okay. Okay. Did you have, was it just beer or was it a mix of mixed drinks, liquor?
I don't remember.
Okay, you don't remember? How long you been downtown tonight?
So I came downtown 10 p.m.
Okay, and you've been down here the whole time?
Yeah.
Have you been drinking the whole time?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you had a DUI before?
I've almost had a DUI before, yes.
Okay. Do you have anything else in the car besides, like, you got your phone, wallet, purse?
No, sir. You can search me if you want.
Okay. I just want to make sure. All right. Because at this point in time, you are going to be under arrest for DUI, okay?
Okay. That's
all right.
Fine.
Just put your hands behind your back.
The police had responded appropriately because of her infelicitous nature. Momentarily, the officer notified her about the impending procedures and took her to the rightful place.
You're turning your hands this way? Yep, just like that.
Would you like to get your phone and wallet or anything out of the car?
You gotta keep your hands just like that, okay? Alright. You got her. Is it okay if this officer go? Well, I mean, is this officer ready to roll up your windows? Your car can stay here. I'm fine. I'm not going to tear your car. It's a public lot, so just remember your car is going to be here at Lumpkin Street across from the big church. No, it's public. Yeah, it's public park spot. So just remember that your car is going to be across from the big church here, okay? And this is Lumpkin Street.
Yeah, I remember.
Okay. All right, you come back to my car. Well, you want to get your shoes?
No.
You sure?
Do I?
I mean, it's like, up to you. I can't say you can't get them.
I can get them.
You want to wear them?
Yeah, if it makes it easier.
What, you got flip-flops on?
She has tennis shoes. No,
I have slip-on tennis shoes.
Where are they at?
Oh, they're passenger, maybe. Passenger.
Passenger side.
They're white heelers.
Oh, those are tennis shoes. That's not slide on.
Yeah. I mean, they basically are. I can put them on.
Where do you live?
Okay. Do you have a purse or anything?
No, ma'am.
She's got her little thingy on her.
I have my wallet and my keys are in the ignition.
She didn't put them on.
Sorry. You got it. I'm okay. Yeah, I'll have to put them on the back of my heels.
All right. Lift this heel up.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Lift it up. Lift your heel up. Yep. So I can try to.
Got it. Right. Thank you.
Yep. Let me walk back to my car, okay? My partner's going to search you real quick when we get to my car. You walk on the side. My car is that one.
Oh, okay.
Do you have anything on you? Did a sticker poke me?
No, ma'am.
Okay. You don't have any pockets on it?
No, not in these guys.
Just checking to make sure you don't have anything on you before you go.
It's okay.
So this is just your...
This is my wallet.
You got it already?
Yeah, I got it already. Erica. All right, Erica, how old are you?
27.
27, okay.
Or 25.
25, okay. All right, so I have to read this to you, okay? This is an implied consent for people over 21, okay?
Okay.
The state of Georgia has conditioned your privilege to drive on how the state upon your submission to a state administered chemical test of your blood, breath, urine, or other body substance for the purpose of determining if you are under the influence of alcohol or drugs. If you refuse this testing, your Georgia's driver's license or privilege to drive on the highways of the state will be suspended for a minimum period of 1 year. Your refusal to submit to blood or urine testing may be offered into evidence against you at trial. If you submit to testing and the results indicate an alcohol concentration of 0.08 grams or more, your Georgia's driver's license or privilege to drive on the highways of the state may be suspended for a minimum period of 1 year. After first submitting to the requested state test, you are entitled to an additional chemical test of your blood, breath, urine, or other body substance at your own expense for qualified person of your own choosing. Will you submit to the state emergency chemical test of your breath?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Alright, sit tight for me, okay?
Appreciate it, both.
Hey, what was your response now?
She had a light on, and then once I got behind her, she said to maintain lights every time.
Alright. Yeah, alright, cool. No headlights and freedom of
taking. I lights and try to get her, cut them on, never did turn them on. And then she drove off at the red light and then she leave.
Okay.
Gone and pull her over. She pulled out. I guess where that bar she said she was at. She had just pulled
out. I remember.
The bar and then, yeah.
Okay.
The lights. I can, give me right, what you want me to do? Write a, give me right that?
I'm good.
Sure?
Yeah. I just got to do the tickets. Yeah. Three tickets. Three tickets. Headlights. Fair light headlights. Fair to maintain lane in the DUI. Appreciate it.
Go downtown.
Yeah.
In your front yard.
377-375. You can put it right there. Can he run the intox for me? Yeah, can you run intox for me? So I'm gonna route this to the downtown substation, one female.
Dispatch has been
updated.
Yeah, well, it looks like there's a history with these two, or with her calling on him over the past year.
Copy. I'll advise. Does she want to be?
Hey, man, what's on the phone?
I'll bet. Alright, step up for me. And we're gonna go inside this downtown police station, okay?
Okay.
Alright, go walk to that.
Mm-hmm.
You can walk down the stairs for me.
Oh, yeah.
He advised the leaning subject. He does have a local 29 reference probation violation for assault. But again, she did say he's out of one. Apparently, he lived on the street with her. also applied. Officer safety can remove handcuffs and no stolen use of 41.
I have to grab that one. Thank you, sir. All right, do me a favor. Have a seat right here. Who did that? Who did that?
That's just getting higher
picture. That's just getting higher picture. Yeah, you see, that's that officer right there, actually.
Oh.
Yeah.
You know why it's like that?
Whoa.
So that all the young people feel better.
That's how you're going to look for real.
Yeah, we'll see, y'all.
Ooh, boy, what you got? Some chicken nuggies.
Aggressive check should be, you and Hunt's check should be on the way soon for Preacher.
Are they coming out?
Well, they should be. They sent me an email, said everything was good. And they put it in to generate it. And next Saturday, you know you want to come work, right?
Leader already got her.
Back off.
Oh, she getting double with cookies, man.
I better get two boxes.
What time do you get off Saturday morning? I got a 5K at twilight. At twilight at 7:30 in the morning. Yeah.
3 miles. Who ran 3 miles?
I'll pay you 4 hour minimum.
I got you. Yeah, I got it. Here's Stan's little notebook.
Shortly after, Erica was escorted to the downtown precinct. Law enforcement was prepared to proceed with the necessary actions regarding her misdeeds.
Okay, cool. Well, don't worry, this is not gonna hurt you. It's just a misdemeanor. It will show up on your record, though. I will say that. But we've arrested judges, lawyers for DUI, and they still have their jobs. So.
Yeah. This is my second one. So.
This is your second one?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know. We'll see.
3 7. Can I get a driver's history for the driver I have in the call, please?
Dispatch has been updated.
I would say that if you know you're going to go out and be drinking, I mean, you live close enough to where you possibly could walk. I would walk with a group of friends, or, you know, you always have the option of Ubering. So I would just err on the side of caution. If you feel like that you're going to just go out and have a good time, just keep your car parked wherever it is and get a ride home, okay? All right, let's not make this a habit, because when you start making it a habit, the judges are going to see it, and they're not going to be so lenient if you continue to make it a habit. All right.
Calls me waiting outside for me.
Can I help y'all?
Sunday is wearing a gray shirt.
My friend got arrested. Short.
Okay, and what are you doing?
I'm trying to get her out.
We're picking up someone from the center. They just got arrested.
Okay. And where did you drive here?
We Ubered over here, so we're going to go pick them up and then Uber back.
All right. One female. Okay, so as far as George is concerned, you don't have, this is gonna be your first DUI. Okay. So like I said, you should be able to get out by the time you get out, it'll probably be 6 a.m. by the time you get out. Somewhere in there. To that door right there.
Erica was charged with the following offenses: headlights off, failure to maintain lane or improper driving on the road, and DUI. While Erica got caught for numerous malicious acts while she was driving on the road, our next individual showed her carelessness when she committed alcohol-related offenses at such a young age for a second time.
I'm gonna kill myself, do you understand?
The incident revolved around a 19-year-old female named Ellie. On the 24th of February, 2024, in Pullman, Whitman County, Washington, the officers were out near the campus of Washington State University dealing with a disturbance when Officer Harris observed a vehicle driving the wrong way on a one-way street. Soon, he reached out to the vehicle to see what was wrong. Right after the approach, the officer began questioning Ellie and demanded to check something essential. Due to her suspicious demeanor, the officer showed a willingness to examine her. What was her response to this inquiry?
Hi, where are you going?
I'm trying to go home. Is there something going on here?
Yeah, it's called a one-way street.
Oh, oops. I'm sorry. I did
the other way.
Should I go back that way? I can turn around.
So, I'm not sure if it's you or not. I'm smelling a whole lot of alcohol. How much have you had to drink tonight?
I have not drank anything tonight, sir.
Oh, okay.
I just dropped my friends off at Fights, or actually my upstairs roommates.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. They just were complaining about not having a ride.
Do you have a driver's license with you?
Yes. Would you like to see that?
Where's home?
Do you know where the Grove is?
Absolutely.
Yes,
I've been here
sir.
For 25 years, so...
Oh, really? Okay, those are good cars.
I pretty much know every place.
that would be home for me. Okay. And then do you want insurance or registration at all?
No, I don't need that right now.
Okay.
So can I check your eyes real quickly just to make sure
yes,
that you're
sir.
Safe?
Do you need, like, I can do a full field sobriety test?
I don't think that's necessary.
Okay.
So if you just kind of turn and face me right in your seat.
Yeah, you go fast.
Can you
yeah.
see my finger right there?
Yes,
so
sir.
Follow it with your eyes only. Don't move your head. How old are you?
I'm 19 years old.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So you haven't had any alcohol to drink tonight?
No, sir.
Okay, there's no resting nystagmus, but your eyes are bouncing a little bit.
Okay.
Which means that you probably have had something to drink.
At about 8 p.m., I did have a glass of wine.
Okay.
But that has been the last thing that I drank tonight.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. I'll be right back. Okay, here's what I got. Wrong way and on one way.
Yep.
19-year-old female driver. I got a strong odor of alcohol from the car. She said she just drops friends off. I had her do just turn towards me and do gaze in the car, and everything was dead on center. But then she was bouncing a little bit, following.
When she's so, talking, you smell anything, or?
I can't say that I smelled anything from her breath. So a minute ago, she said she's doing willing to do tests, but that's what I got.
Okay, cool. Get her info?
I just ran her name, yep.
Okay. Anything pop up?
Nope.
Can she fit? Yeah.
Hello, Ellie, right?
Yes, sir.
Hi, my name's Officer Legg with Pullman PD. So what were you getting into tonight? It sounds like you dropped off some friends.
Yeah, I dropped my friends off at Vita.
Despite her best attempt at showing soberness, the police displayed ultimate cautiousness and decided to go with the protocols that were designed for such moments. After completing the methods, the deputy probed her again to seek more precise answers. Due to her malevolence in each act, law enforcement proceeded with strong measures.
I did not realize that it was a one-way.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
So they walked up and they informed me that it was a one-way.
Okay.
Yeah, that's my bad.
Okay, no problem. It smells a little bit like alcohol in the car. I'm not sure if it's from you or the vehicle, but is it all right if we do some tests with you before you drive again?
That's okay, yeah.
So what I'll have you do is I'll have you step out of the vehicle.
Yeah.
We'll walk over here to that sidewalk.
Okay.
And we'll just do some tests, okay?
Okay, yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Do you want to...
Yep. And we'll be here too with it, so...
Yeah, if you want to hang with him,
yeah.
I'll move
yeah,
car.
Sure. Pullman 448, I'm out with 06. Step on over here.
Okay.
This looks like a flat area, real nice.
Yeah.
Right here.
Okay, yes, sir.
So what I'm going to do, run through a few tests. The first one I'm going to do is check in your eyes, okay? Step
yeah.
forward a little bit more, run a little bit of a curve. All right. So before we begin, do you have anything medical that would keep you from falling, walking a straight line, standing
no,
on one leg?
No,
how about your eyes? Do you have any contacts? Or?
No, I'm good with my eyes.
Okay,
yes.
Okay. So what I'll do is have you, I'm going to... shine a light like this. Let me know if it's bothering your eyes.
Okay, yeah.
See the tip of my pen? Where it clicks? I want you to follow that with your eyes and your eyes only. Do not move your head, okay? Okay, doing good. Just follow my, follow the pen. Good, and can you dip your chin, down, yep, just
yes.
like that. All right, same thing, follow this with your eyes only.
Ooh, that's how my field of vision.
There, how about that right there?
Yeah, there you go.
Okay. So with that, we're gonna do another test.
Okay. Okay.
This one's going to be called a walk and turn test.
Yeah, I've seen this.
You've seen this one. Okay. So all we're going to do is I'm going to put you in a starting position, and you'll stay just like that until I tell you to begin, okay?
Cool. Okay.
So with that, what it looks like is you're going to have your feet together.
Right.
Hands at your side, just like that. Okay. And imagine from your left toe a straight line going right down the sidewalk, okay?
Okay.
And put your right foot in front of your left toe, like so. Heel to toe, just like that. That's your starting position. I want you to stay that way until I tell you to do otherwise, okay?
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So with this, the way the test is going to go, I'm going to demonstrate for you. So you'll be standing like so, just like you are. And you can watch my feet if you'd like, just so you know what's going on. So I'm going to demonstrate and speak, tell you how it works. Right. So you're going to take 9 steps forward, heel to toe, and you count each step out loud. It's going to look like this. 1, 2, 3. Because I'm demonstrating, I'm going to do only 3. You're going to do 9, okay? Once you get to your 9th step, you're going to keep your forward foot on the ground. And with a series of small steps,
okay,
you just multiple steps. There you go. And you'll begin 9 steps again back to the beginning. 1, 2, 3. I've done 3. You will do 9. Do you understand?
Right. I
understand. Okay. So something to think about when you do this, count every step out loud. Keep your eyes on your feet, your hands at your side. And at no point in time do you stop the test until you've completed it. You understand?
Okay. So 9 there and 9 back.
That's correct. Yep.
Okay. Yes, sir.
You have any questions?
No, sir.
All right. You may begin.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay. Next test is going to be one leg stand.
Okay, yeah.
So what that one is, it's even more simple than the last one, okay?
Yeah.
So you're going to keep your, this is your starting position right here, hands at your side. Okay. You stay just like that until I tell you to do otherwise. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so from here, what I'll have you do when I tell you to begin, you're going to keep your hands at your side, lift one leg above the ground approximately 6 inches. I don't care which leg it is.
Okay.
So just take a guess at 6 inches.
Okay.
You're going to pick up that leg with a straight knee and a toe pointed.
Okay.
And then you're going to count out loud until I tell you to stop. You're going to count like this. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, and so on and so forth, okay?
Okay.
You'll count that way until I tell you to stop, okay?
Okay.
So something to think about. Keep your eyes on your toe. Keep your knees straight, toe pointed, hands at your side, okay?
Okay.
And make sure you count the way I instructed you. Do you have any questions?
No, sir.
All right. So with that, hang on just a second. And go ahead and begin.
1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005, 1006, 1007, 1008, 1009, 1010, 1011, 1012, 1013, 1014, 1015, 1016, 1017, 1018, 1019, 1020.
Okay, you can stop.
1.
Thank you. Okay, and the next thing I'm going to have you do would be a PBT. It's called a PBT. It's short for a preliminary breath test, okay?
Okay, yeah.
Is that something you're willing to do? It's
That's
voluntary?
That's a breathalyzer test.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay.
Do you have anything in your mouth right now, ma'am?
No, sir.
I'm assuming you don't know how to use these old ones.
That's a new old one.
So I'll show you here. So all you do is just kind of blow that way.
Okay, yes, sir.
I'll show you here. It shows 3 zeros.
Right.
So take a deep breath in. Blow hard. And stop. Let me talk with Officer Leggett real quick here. What are you thinking before you see this?
All I had were a couple on the eyes, some bouncing, maybe not enough for a, it's going to be a point or two, possibly.
Okay. Nothing on the other tests?
Just walking, following directions, I'm going to turn at the most.
Okay.
And as far as the one leg is standing, I'm spot on.
So what do you want to
do? As of right now, I was going to say she's impaired and park it and walk. My friend come pick her up.
Well, if she's impaired, what is that?
No.
Just Think about your language, if that's what you're saying.
Yeah, she's under 21 here, so if she's over 22, that's it. Yeah.
If she's over 21, impairment is the law, right? Mm-hmm. You can't drive while impaired. Okay.
I didn't have a lot on the eyes. I just had two.
Okay. So like your guess would be that she's under an 08. Mm-hmm. But, okay. And then, but there is some exhibiting signs of alcohol, you would say?
Mm-hmm.
How much
did
she say to you? Nothing.
Nothing. Yeah. I actually don't think I clearly asked that question if she had any.
What do you want to do?
I do a couple quick questions with her, and based on those, I move forward.
What's that?
I do a couple quick questions, see if she's had anything to drink, and move forward.
Okay.
If she has, then yes. I'll move for another. Yes. The eyes. I only had two hits on the eyes.
So then what pretty much you have is bad driving, odor, and lack of smooth pursuit?
Lack of smooth pursuit and maximum deviation.
Maximum deviation should give us at least 06-ish, I think. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll save this for me.
Okay, so just a couple questions before we finish up here. Have you had anything to drink tonight?
I did at 8 p.m. I had a glass of wine.
8 p.m., okay. Just one glass?
Yeah, well, I had two glasses of wine. Okay. Like a refill. I made dinner, and then I dropped these people off.
Okay, so 8 p.m., you had the two glasses of wine, and then you took your friends to where they were going. Where'd you take them again?
What's that one? Phyta?
Okay, and you came from the Grove?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you had the two glasses of wine from the at the Grove?
I ate dinner and took my time before I came.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Well, at this time, we're seeing that you kind of have, you're exhibiting signs of impairment based on the drive, the way they stopped you, and smell of alcohol coming out the window when you're speaking. And we weren't sure if it was you or if it was the people that were in the car before you, but based on having drank alcohol, two glasses of wine at 8 p.m. Okay, so with that right there, you're under arrest for DUI, okay? So just put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back.
Under arrest.
For DUI. Yes, ma'am.
I drove from right there to right here.
I understand, ma'am.
I'm gonna kill myself. Do you understand? I don't. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm actually killing myself. This is the last straw. This is the last. No, I'm gonna kill myself. My mom is gonna disown me. I'm done. Do you understand? I'm not drunk, sir.
Face forward, man. Face forward.
No, sir. I'm sorry. I understand. I moved 2 inches down the street, sir. I had a glass of wine like forever ago. Are you genuinely serious? Because I know these Pullman cops, y'all have like a quota you gotta reach or something. You need to get your certain amount of arrests in for the day.
I've never heard of a quota, miss. We're gonna walk towards my car, okay? So step this way. And you turn to the right.
What happens to my car, sir?
Oh, we can park it for you. Walk that way, miss. Or if you have someone you want to come pick it up. Someone who hasn't been drinking and they have a license. So go ahead and face the car right there. Thank you.
So, I got a minor in possession a little while ago, and I was in the pre-charge and diversion program, and I'm guessing that's all now.
It depends on, we'll have to find out more about it.
If I commit another crime, I'm done, so a DUI, I'm guessing it's...
Can you step to your right for me?
Yeah.
We'll find
out. I don't want anybody driving my car, by the way.
Okay, can you step a little bit more?
So, ma'am... The options for the car is you could allow an officer to park
it
somewhere.
No, I don't want an officer to park it. I would like to let somebody come and get it for me. I would like to call somebody that I trust and have them drive it.
Okay. Can they get it out of the road quickly? Or
yes,
if I call
I can call somebody.
Okay. We can work on that real quick here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
You have a phone with you?
Yes, I do. It's in my pocket.
It's in your pocket.
It was. Maybe it's not anymore. Or maybe it's still in my car.
Possibly in your car. Nothing right now, sir. Back pockets. What I'll have you do is I'll have you step in this car. We'll sit down in there and we'll get you a phone call and you can call your friend to have them come pick it up.
Okay.
Watch your head. Hang out here, we'll get you that phone call, okay? So, miss, you're going to be audio-visual recorded while you're
I
in
know,
here, okay?
I've seen helicopter videos
okay.
on YouTube.
So, phone and cord?
Yep, it's in the aux cord. So I want to read you something real quick, miss, okay?
Yes, read them. Okay.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can be used against you in a court of law. You have the right at this time to talk to a lawyer and have him present with you while you're being questioned. If you can't afford to hire a lawyer, one will be appointed to represent you before questioning if you wish. You can decide at any time to exercise these rights and not answer any questions or make any statements. Do you understand these rights I've read to you?
Yes, can I call?
Having these rights in mind, do you wish to talk to us now?
I personally do not wish to talk to you, but may I ask one question?
Sure.
Can I call somebody to get my car along yep. with call my mother?
We got your phone right now.
So the first thing is the vehicle. So if
yes.
you can get someone to come within 10 to 15 minutes,
yes,
we can release it to them. If not, you can allow one of us to park it. I know you say you don't want to do that, and that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
The third option, if those don't happen, is us towing it to an impound lot.
I can get someone to come and get it, but if I... That's not going to be my call, right? Because I would like to call
my
mother.
No, we'll let you through the phone.
I would like to call my mother.
Sure. So right now, the vehicle, we're not going to deprive you of the phone ever, like just not kidnap or anything like that.
Still call my
yes.
mom, right?
Yeah. So, the first thing, the car, we'll deal with. Mike, can I talk to you for a second? Okay.
I'm not lying. You're looking to be the reason I killed myself.
What's up?
Okay.
The officer outlined to Ellie the method they were taking regarding her offenses. Despite showing soaring emotions, the officers remained unfazed and went with the correct protocols. Her continuous display of belligerency made things worse for her. Instead of accepting her misdeed, she pointed fingers at law enforcement for her current predicament.
Well, we just have a quick correction for you. You're not under arrest for DUI. It's minor, operating vehicle after consuming alcohol, okay?
You said DUI the first time.
Yeah.
So you're not good at being a cop.
So DUI is going to be if you were over 21.
Yeah, but you don't even know what
do
you're
you
arresting
make a phone call?
For yourself, do you?
Mbaka. It's minor, operating vehicle after
yeah,
consuming alcohol.
Yeah, now you do, but you didn't even in the beginning.
Do you want to make a phone call or are we going to drive now?
Yeah, just drive. Honestly, you guys can take my car.
Well, we're just going to park it nearby.
Yeah, okay, go ahead. I just want to call my mom.
Okay. Well, when we get to the station, we'll do another test and then we'll call your mom.
Okay. Right?
So because you're under 21, the charge is different. It's not going to be a DUI.
I got an MIP earlier in January. And
okay.
So diversion program is done, you know? I don't get to do that anymore, and now I don't know what the happens, and...
Well, this charge is not a gross misdemeanor because you're only a minor operating vehicle.
It doesn't matter what the happens.
After consuming alcohol.
My mom is a religious and if I do she's gonna disown me, and I'm done. So
this will just be a misdemeanor?
I'm killing myself either way!
Okay.
myself either
I really hope you don't do that.
I'm going to take all of the Benadryl in my cabinet because that's exactly what I'm going to do. And I've been planning to do that for a very long time. This is just the f***ing cherry on top, isn't it?
I really hope you don't do that.
Yeah, I'm planning on doing it. Thanks. Thank you so much for convincing me. I've been really hoping for a reason to leave this planet.
Okay, miss. Ready to stand up? Step on out here. Walk this way.
Don't touch me. I don't like being touched by strangers.
All right. Well, just walk this way. Just walk this way. You're gonna be all right.
I will walk with you. Please don't touch me, though. Please, 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 please. I really hate old men. I'm sorry. I don't like. I don't like men. Please,
walk this
please.
Way.
I was raped when I was little. Please don't touch me. Please don't touch me.
Talk to stuff. All right. Let's walk this way. See that brown chair? Go sit on that brown chair right there.
did you by chance want to speak to an attorney tonight?
Yeah.
I can make a phone call and you can talk to them alone in there, okay? Okay, so we'll walk in this room here and I'll make a phone call for an attorney so you can talk to him if you'd like, okay? Do you still want to talk to him? All right. Step on up here. We'll go in this room. This is where the phone is. Yep, have a seat. We'll see who picks up.
Hi,
is this Roger Sandberg?
Yes.
Hi, my name is Officer Legler with Pullman PD. I have someone here who would like to speak to you. She's under arrest for a minor operating motor vehicle after consuming alcohol.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to hand her off to you. You speak as long as you want. When you're ready to leave, just knock on the door, okay? Hey, Ellie. Are you all done? You all done, Ellie? Come on out. After we do a few things here, I'll have you call your mom if you still want to. Okay. Just have a seat at the brown chair. Could you just do that to your head there? I don't want you to be hurt. Are you all right? I see you got a mark on your head there. You feeling okay? Do you want me to get a medic out here to look at you? Okay. So what we're going to do here is a few questions. I'll read some things to you. If you need any explanation, let me know, okay? So the next line you're going to sign, this is, I have decided not to exercise these rights. That means you're willing to speak to us. If you're not willing to speak, then you wouldn't sign that line.
I would like to exercise my right to remain silent if there's not an attorney present.
You can do that. That's okay. So you're not going to sign this next line that says you waive those rights.
I don't want to talk unless I know who I'm talking to and what I'm talking about and
okay.
Attorney and all that.
Further, you are now being asked to submit to a test of your breath, which consists of two separate samples of your breath taken independently to determine alcohol concentration. You are now advised that you have the right to refuse this breath test and that if you refuse, your driver's license permit or privilege to drive will be revoked or denied by the Department of Licensing for at least 1 year. And your refusal to submit to this test may be used in a criminal trial. So I'm going to ask this next question. You don't have to speak if you want, but you have to check a box here. Will you now submit to a breath test? It's yes or no. Would you like to check that box?
Sure.
Yep. Did subject express any confusion regarding implied consent warnings?
Confusion regarding what?
Implied consent warnings. So that's this page I just read to you. So it says you can refuse this breath test if you'd like.
I'll do the breath test, but I'm very confused about everything. I won't lie. So
okay.
I can't say I'm not confused.
Okay. Yeah. Would you like me to answer any questions for you? If you can make
it. I don't even know what questions to ask.
Okay.
Because I don't even know what's happening to
yeah.
this.
So to begin with, you were under arrest.
I understand.
Okay.
That. But then what happens? Do I have to pay? How much money do I have to pay?
Oh,
and
that
then
part.
Yeah. I was already in the pre-charge and diversion mm-hmm. program, so I'm guessing that's out the window.
Did
and
you mention that to the attorney?
Yes.
That's more their
and then
field.
And he just said, oh, that's bad. Mm-hmm. And then that was it. So
okay.
I don't know what... I don't know. That's
okay.
what I'm confused about, is because there's no answers. And I know that you guys don't know, because obviously you haven't been there for
yeah.
whatever. You know, you don't know these things, but
okay.
I don't know these things.
Do you want me to try to get a different attorney for you? We can try a different.
No, because no attorney knows what's going on either.
They do this pretty often.
But they don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. That's why I'm just freaking out, is because I just don't know what's going to happen to me with this.
So I'll put in the box here, you had confusion, yes, and I'll make a note. It's regarding the, looks like you're on a diversion program already, right? Okay.
Yes,
so I'll say.
But part of that was I cannot commit another crime.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm guessing another MIP counts as a crime.
Yeah, that would be the case.
So then what happens if you get an MIP stacked on top of an MIP?
Well, this is an MIP. That would be minor in possession. This is minor. You're driving a vehicle. You're under 21.
and you're over 0.02.
So that's even worse. So then what happens?
That's for them to decide how that goes. That's what this hearing form is for you.
So I don't want to sign anything because if I don't know, mm-hmm. how am I supposed to agree?
What I'll say is you had confusion on that topic, and I'll make a note of it, okay? I'll write down, let's see here, it's you're already in a diversion program, and you're wondering...
But now I'm not, because it's over.
Well, you were in a diversion program, and what does that mean now for you, okay?
It means it's over.
I don't know how that would work. You are Ellie, right? So here's some more questions for you. You don't have to answer them if you don't want to, okay? Did you still want to speak? You said you didn't want to speak unless you had an attorney present. Does that still stand? Okay, so I'm not going to ask any of these questions for you.
Do you like your life?
I do.
How?
Yeah, it's good.
Like getting people in trouble.
Well,
it's good, gives you a rush of power.
No, the hard part is when people drive when they've been drinking, even if they think they're all right, sometimes people get hurt when it happens. So that's what we're out there doing right now. Because it can be sad sometimes when someone else gets hurt.
Even when your low is 0.47, which is half of the normal.
You had a 0.06.
0.06. Yeah. Still below.
If you were 21, that would be below, correct?
Yes, if I was 21.
But because you're under 21, the maximum you can have
is
0.02.
I understand that. Okay. I just don't agree with it. But that's my personal opinion, and I understand that that's a very personal opinion, and that it differs. That it doesn't align with the law. But.
So while we're waiting, I'm just filling out some other paperwork. This is saying you have... This will be your court date. It's going to be on Monday.
Next Monday?
Yeah, the one coming up. Yeah. It's going to be Monday at 3 p.m. It'll be in Colfax. And this is saying you received it. Are you willing to sign that right there? I'm going to give that to you when you leave here.
It's the last for me.
Yep. What I'll do is once you sign it, I'll make a copy. You get one, I get one.
Okay.
This is signing saying you'll be there and that you understand conditions of release. And these are your conditions of release.
The cop informed Ellie's mother about her malpractices and the oncoming specialized modus operandi she would face. After completing the test, the officer took the appropriate step in terms of her intangibility. While her bizarre behavior was still at large, the officer briefed her about the looming trots.
Mom's Stephanie.
Hi, Stephanie.
I'm in Seattle right now.
Hello.
Hi, I'm just wondering what's going on and what's going to happen to Ellie.
Well, right now we're going to be doing another test. It's a breathalyzer test.
Okay.
With a Draeger machine. She's in our holding facility right now, and we're basically just going through the steps of this process. It's not a DUI.
Okay.
So she's a minor. That means she's under 21. She had consumed alcohol. So her legal limit for driving after consuming alcohol is 0.02. She blew a 0.06. So she is over that limit.
Okay.
So once again, it's not a DUI. It's going to be minor operating a motor vehicle after consuming alcohol. And that is a lesser offense. It's a misdemeanor. DUI is going to be a gross misdemeanor. So I don't know how that's going to affect her other... I guess she had a past...
She had an MIP just recently. Okay. Yeah.
And I'm sure that will affect it. I do not know how. The judge is going to find that out. They'll make their decision on that. She'll have a hearing on Monday.
Oh, no.
But right now...
Is there any way you guys can let her go? Because she was just helping a friend.
I can't do that. It's unfortunate. I do have to start this test, though. We can call you afterwards. But this has to happen now, okay?
Okay. All right. So, and this is, what kind of test are you doing on her?
It's a breathalyzer test. A breathalyzer test. I'll call you back when we're done, okay? We'll try to call you back.
And what if she refuses? Like, what?
She is allowed to.
Refuse this or not?
She is allowed to, and she checked the box saying she would.
I signed saying I would, and the attorney told me to do it before he hung up on me, so I'm guessing it's probably smarter to do it.
Stephanie, I have to go now.
All right.
We can call you back later.
Please call me back at this number then and let me know what's going on.
Okay. Have a nice night. Bye.
Thank you.
I'm just curious. The field sobriety tests?
Yep.
I mean, I faced that. You can't lie. It was just the breathalyzer. I'm not drunk. I'm just... I have alcohol in my system for a minor. Mm-hmm. Correct?
Well, you showed signs of impairment.
Was it like the eyeball
Yeah, so that when we do, it's called HGN.
And the eyeball thing.
Yeah, the eyeball thing, that's right, yeah. So your eyes can't hide. As much as you can walk straight or stand straight, the eyes just don't hide much.
Yeah. I know they don't.
And those will give us certain clues, and then also the smell of alcohol.
No matter how sober you feel, if you have alcohol in your system, your eyes are going to f*** that shit.
And a little bit, like, I mean, you just wouldn't, it wouldn't tell, but what you had was enough to give us a hint. So this thing's going to be doing, it's warming up, and then after that we'll do the test, and it should be done after that.
You'll probably get like 18 arrests a night on Cleveland.
No, surprisingly not. No. So what I'll have you do, you can sit down or stand up when you do it. It's just like blowing up a balloon, just like you did the other test. It'll be a little bit longer though, the other one's quick. You put your lips on that, make it a good seal, and blow as hard as you can. I'll tell you when to stop, okay? You can begin. Good. Yep, just like that. Keep blowing. Good, 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 good. Good, good, good. Keep going. Go, go, go. Okay, stop. And the machine's going to tell us what happened, and we'll go from there. You have one more test like that, and we're done. After that, the only annoying thing we have to do is a few more papers to sign. You have to sit in the holding cell to detox, pretty much.
And that's complete, too.
Yep, there's a bathroom in there. Yep.
Hope you don't think I dislike you. I think you're a cool guy. I just find that certain things I just don't understand. And that's not your fault. I know you're doing your job. I just... I'm very confused and I'm very annoyed and there's a lot of things I don't like about the law in general. But that's personal opinions.
I know.
A lot of things I don't like about the government in general.
Okay, ready for another one. Same thing, okay? Whenever you're ready, take a deep breath. Good, keep going. Go, 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 go. Go, keep it up. That may be good enough. All right, have a seat. It's gonna do some more thinking. It's gonna print out. We'll go from there. So I noticed over here he had another ID. What's the deal with that? So it printed out two copies. One's for me, one's for you. I'm gonna sign them both. So you can see what the test ended with. So your first test was a 0.068, and your second test was a 0.070. They're different because there's a different kind of test they do. Okay, the machine has two different tests. So that's going to be for yours to keep. I'll put that in your pile of records. So with that, do you have any questions about this test we just took? This is the evidentiary test right here. The one we did in the field is not evidentiary. That's just to see where you are. This one right here, this is the one that the courts will be looking at.
The one that's higher?
Yeah. That's why this is a much more, it's a better test, more scientific. So with that, I'll put this with your papers. Right now, you're going to be, I'll put you in a holding cell. There's a bathroom in there. I'll give you a cup. We should have cups around here, maybe. And that'll be there. You'll be there for the maximum of 6 hours. Probably less, because you've already been in here about an hour. Step over here. There's a bathroom in here as well. Water, bathroom. I'll get you a blanket real quick. I'll be back in just a second. Alright, I got a blanket for you. Here you go. Blanket. Here you go. Hey, Ellie.
Yeah?
How are we doing?
I just want to know what time it is.
Sure, yeah. It's 4:17, okay?
A.M.?
Yeah, A.M., yeah.
I've been here for like 4 hours.
You have, yeah. It's pretty common. It's not absurd for that to happen because we want to make sure you're at least closer to being fully sober before we cut you loose.
Okay.
And that's essentially what's going to happen today, okay? So if you're wondering what's the game plan from here, I wrote up a citation, which is something we certainly have to do because there, you know, there's some infractions. So you'll get a citation, we'll release you from here, and your friend, I think her name's Paris? Is that, okay, so she called us, is that someone you would be okay driving home with? So I will contact her, we have her number, I'll find out if she can get here, maybe within an hour, we're aiming to get you out of here, okay? And you will be able to walk out of the front of the building.
Just call her fast.
Yeah,
the
yeah.
Here,
getting a headache? Okay. Okay. How's your head feeling? Yeah, your head. You got a little bump on it. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to work on getting, we'll contact Paris. Was she drinking last night? I'm going to ask her if she has a good ID and if she's intoxicated. Because if she has been drinking and she drives here, she might be in the cell next to you, okay? Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll ask. And is there anyone else you might have an idea about? Anyone else in the area that could drive? Okay. So I'll call her, we'll see what we can figure out, and I'll let her know that that would be the situation. So we'll make sure she's clear and sober, or someone else that she might know. Otherwise, there's always the option of walking. There's that. Okay, you don't have to, just we want to make sure you got a good driver, okay? So other than that, we'll work on that. All right, well with that, I'm going to work on a few things. Like I said, I'm aiming for maybe an hour more, we'll get you out of here, okay? You'll have all your stuff given back to you. The only thing I had to take was the dab pen. I took the pen and the capsule. You had an air tag on it. I took that off. You can have that back. Yeah, and the fake ID, of course, you had to take that one. But otherwise, I'll get working on getting you out of here. Like I said, maybe another hour, right? All right, you all right? Did you need a... I mean, there's water there if you wanted a drink. Yeah. Okay, and just to give you an update, I remember we talked about what is the charge and what does it equate to. And it's not an MIP. Remember we talked about that? It's a little bit more than that. It's not a DUI. And what tends to happen with these cases, because you're under 21, sometimes our prosecutor knocks it down to neg 1, which is negligent driving first degree. That just means you're driving in a way that's not safe for other people and you hadn't, you're... had signs of alcohol or intoxication, okay? So it might get bumped down to that, which is less than both the other charges, okay? So just keep that in mind. This is just misdemeanor stuff. Really, the prosecutor's just gonna... Remember you mentioned you had a question about, what was it? You're on a diversion program? Do you remember you mentioned that? So all the prosecutor's gonna do is see you were on the program, you messed up again, and they're going to revisit that, but it's not going to be like all of a sudden it's a huge charge. Does that make sense? They're just going to look at your case again. All right? All right, I'll get working on things. All right?
Ellie was arrested for being a minor driving a vehicle after consuming alcohol. She also revealed that she was arrested before for being a minor in possession of alcohol. Her criminal case is still open. While Ellie was caught drunk when she was too young, our next individual is someone who lost her senses due to consuming a massive amount of liquor and ultimately faced backlash from the authorities.
Talk to me. Are you okay?
What was that?
Well, you drove off the road.
The incident revolved around a 22-year-old woman named Gloria Dumas. On the 10th of March, 2023, in Santa Fe, New Mexico, the officers responded to a welfare check of a potential vehicle crash on the roadside. Upon arriving, the officer noticed the driver was asleep in the vehicle. Soon, they sensed something was wrong and decided to look into the matter closely. Right after coming near the vehicle, the police tried to wake up the driver. After she woke up, the authorities instantly issued her a command since they saw something was not okay. Further, she was subjected to various questions from the cops. Nonetheless, her words were snared and it provoked the cops to inspect profoundly.
Hey, you okay? Hey there, Sheriff's Office. Sheriff's office. Hey. Five, one, Santa Fe.
One, go to Santa Fe.
One female occupant appears to be passed out. I'm attempting to wake her up. She is breathing, but not awake.
Santa Fe Stretch, did you want me to start meds that way?
Hey, you okay? Yeah, just to check her out.
Hey, Stretch.
Hey there, wake up. You okay? Talk to me. You okay?
What was that?
Well, you drove off the road. She's awake now. Car was still in drive. I put it in park and shut it off. Hey, can you do me a favor and step out of the car and talk to me?
What's your name, ma'am?
Gloria?
What's that?
Gloria?
Yeah.
Okay.
Gloria, step out of the car for us, okay?
Are you okay? Are you hurt?
No, I'm fine.
So what happened?
I don't know.
Were you... I see, Oh.
Where were you coming from? Gloria?
I don't even know. I don't remember.
Where were you going? Do you remember where you were going?
Home.
Where's home at?
My house.
I mean, yeah, but where's your house?
down Seringo, that was it.
Down Seringo? Do you know where you are right now?
I think I'm by the Bluffs.
No, you're down in Las Campanas. By the MRC. How much have you had to drink tonight?
Too much, obviously.
Yeah, a little bit too much alcohol.
Yeah. Tonight.
When was the last time you drank?
Maybe about an hour ago.
About an hour ago?
Mm-hmm.
Should I 22:55?
Do you want an ambulance to come check you out? Do you feel like you need an ambulance?
No, that's fine.
Okay. Do you want to step out for me? Do you have your ID and stuff?
I only have it on my ID.
Shortly afterward, the authorities told her to show some essential details. The responses were fishy, and concurrently, the police decided to conduct some distinctive methods to check her circumstances. After completing the lengthy process, the authorities were wonderstruck.
Yeah, let's see your ID, if you have it on you. Or at least you know if you know your driver's license number.
Yeah, they only sent it, it's kind of weird. They sent it to me through my email.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys are accurate with that.
No, I haven't heard of it yet, but if you have your driver's license number, that would be sufficient. And you weren't injured at all when you drove off the road here?
Mm-mm.
Do you remember driving off the road?
No.
No?
Yeah, you're kind of over here in this little ditch right here. And when I came up to talk to you, your car was still in drive.
No way.
Yeah, I had to put it in park and shut it off for you. What's your last name, Gloria?
Dumas, D-U-M-A-S.
Okay, and what's your birthday?
2000.
Okay.
All right, Gloria. Yeah. You mind stepping out for me? I'll help you out if you need.
Yeah, of course. Thank you.
Yep. Don't want to lose your step. And we're going to come up here over here, okay?
Okay.
Good?
I just wanted to show you this. You know, I'm trying to find it right away for you. Oh my god, I feel so bad. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. Let's come over here real quick. I got you.
Thank you.
Of course. Hey, can you pull your unit forward a little bit?
Yes.
Just stand right here for me, Glory, okay? Yeah, just right here. I'm going to turn these lights off so they're not flashing in your face, okay?
No worries. It might help.
Yeah. So how much, do you remember how much alcohol you had to drink?
No, not really.
What were you drinking?
It's in the car still.
That, whiskey bottle or,
The Pink Whitney?
The Pink Whitney, there you go.
Yeah.
That's vodka?
Yeah.
Yeah, got you. And do you remember where you were coming from, the last thing you remember? No?
No, I'm pretty lightweight, so.
I got you. How old are you?
I'm 22.
22?
Yeah.
And so I do have some questions, right? I'm going to ask you if you're willing to perform standardized field sobriety tests, okay? It's completely voluntary. Basically, I want you to show me that you're not impaired. I know you've already said that you might have had too much to drink tonight. You know, obviously you drove off the road here. I just want to make sure you're okay, though, okay? Are you willing to do those field sobriety tests?
Yeah, we can do it.
Okay. Have you had any recent head injuries?
No.
You didn't bump your head at all during this?
I bump my head all the time.
Do you have any problems walking or standing? Any problem with your knees, back?
I have a lot of problems with my back.
Do you feel okay, comfortable walking and standing, though?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And balancing on one leg, any issues with that? No? You feel okay?
Yeah.
All right. So what I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you stand right here for me.
Okay.
Right where my light's at. I want you to face me, put your feet together, and put your hands down at your side, okay?
Cool.
You okay?
See, I can't do that.
All right. So I just want you to put your feet together and your hands down by your side, okay? I want you to follow the tip of my finger. Can you see my finger? Do you wear glasses or contacts?
No.
Okay. And you can see my finger, okay? Just follow with your eyes and your eyes only.
Okay.
You're doing good. Just keep following. Stay focused. You okay?
Yeah.
All right. Focus on my finger. Find my finger. There you go. Focus on my finger. Right here. See the tip of my finger?
Yep.
There you go.
right here. There you go. You can see my finger?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Almost done, almost done. Good job, good job. So we are blessed that we have a straight line on a nice solid roadway here, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get you into what's called the start position. Try to step away so you're not leaning on my truck there.
Oh.
Good, just stand right there for me, okay? So I'm gonna get you into what's called the start position. Face the line here. In this start position, I don't want you to start or do anything until I instruct you to do so, okay? Do you understand that? So basically, mm-hmm. Don't start until I tell you to.
Yeah.
So what I want you to do is on this line here, facing this direction, I want you to place your left foot down on that line, okay? Can you do that for me? Just like this. So place your left foot down in the middle of that line. Can you do that? Right there. With your right foot, I want you to bring it directly in front of your left foot, touching heel to toe, just like my feet are right here, okay? Can you do that for me now?
Heel to toe?
Heel to toe, just like my feet are.
Now keep your bad balance.
Okay. Now keep your hands down by your side. Now, again, this is a start position. Stay in this position until I instruct you otherwise. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Okay. So with your hands down by your side.
I can't do it.
Try and stay in that position, okay? I'm going to demonstrate this for you, okay?
Okay.
From this position, what you're going to do is you're going to take a series of 9 heel-to-toe steps forward while counting each step out loud, looking down at your feet, and your hands down by your side. It's going to look just like this. 1, 2, 3. Now, for demonstrational purposes, I took 3 steps. You're going to take 9. Once you get to that 9th step, you're going to keep your lead foot planted. Watch my feet. With your back foot, you're going to take a series of small steps, bringing yourself back around until you're facing the line on the opposite direction. Then you're going to continue just the way you approached. 1, 2, 3, and so on until you get to the 9th step. This is a continuous test, so you're not going to stop anywhere in between.
Okay.
Do you have any questions?
No.
Do you understand the instructions?
Yes.
Go ahead and just get back in that start position, okay? So left foot down, right foot directly in front of the left foot. Hands down by your side.
To walk out into the middle of the road.
It's going back, right?
On the same line. You okay?
Yeah, I feel like I'm
It's alright.
So what I'm going to have you do now is, let's actually have you face this way right here. Face right there. Again, I'm going to demonstrate this position for you. It's called the start position, and I don't want you to start until I tell you to. So this one's a little easier, I guess. You just keep your feet together and your hands down by your side, okay? Can you do that for me?
Yeah.
So again, stay in this position until I instruct you otherwise, okay? From this position, what you're going to do is you're going to lift whatever leg you feel comfortable with approximately 6 inches off the ground. While keeping your hands down by your side, you're going to lift that leg just like this, okay? Now, keep both your legs straight. Keep that foot parallel to the ground about 6 inches. Like, pretend that you have your top of your foot on a Coke can. You're going to look down at your feet, and you're going to, don't start until I tell you to.
Oh.
And you're going to count out loud in this manner. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004, and so on until I instruct you to stop. Now, this is a timed test, so you're not going to stop until I tell you to.
Okay.
Do you understand those instructions?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any questions? Give me 1 second, okay? Go ahead and begin.
1,001?
I can't do it. You don't want to?
If you put your foot down, just continue to keep trying, unless you're done.
Okay.
1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005, 1006, 1007. Okay. All right. One more test that I want you to do for me is turn around and face that direction and bring your right hand back towards the sound of my voice, okay? Let me have your other hand. Does it feel okay?
Yeah.
Do you have any weapons, anything that's gonna stick me, stab me, or poke me?
No, sir.
Can we get a 46 or see if she wants to call?
No, get a 46. We'll have to do a
UCR. Yeah, got it.
Let's come back this way. Again, you have nothing on you that's going to stick me, stab me, or poke me?
No, sir.
Just with the back of my hand in front of my camera and this camera here, I'm just going to check your pocket hoodie, okay?
Yeah, go for it. I should only have my inhaler.
Where's that at?
Because I have my... I think it's in the car still.
Nothing in your bra or anything?
No, sir.
Okay. Actually, stand right here. Hey, Dakota.
The officers questioned her again. Despite her trying to stimulate the topic, the officers remained adamant and handled the situation strictly. Later, a deputy summarized her regarding the impending modes of action.
Do you have insurance on the vehicle? Okay, because of how you drove off the road, I'm going to have to take a crash report, because like the front of the car is kind of damaged.
Are you serious?
A little bit. Yeah, it's a little bit damaged.
Well, it's been damaged in the first place.
Oh, okay. So then maybe it's old. But just because of how you drove off the road, I'm going to have to take a crash report.
Data 5-1, my apologies. Did you say yes to a flatbed?
Let's come back this way. You okay? Watch
it.
Well,
no, better.
Yeah, the good thing is you're not hurt, right? And you didn't hurt anybody.
I'll be hurt eventually.
Watch your step there. Watch your head. All right, now I'm just going to reach across you and put your seatbelt on, okay?
That's fine.
All right.
Hey, Gloria, where do you keep the insurance information to your vehicle?
In the glove compartment.
Okay, cool. Do you know what insurance company you have?
Progressive.
Progressive, gotcha. And what's a good phone number for you?
I don't even know if I want to say
it. It's for the report.
Yeah.
To contact.
Well, it's just, or whoever the owner of the vehicle is. I mean, are you the owner?
No. It's my brother.
It's your brother? Okay. What's your brother's name?
Lyle.
Okay. And what's his phone number?
I didn't know that.
Okay. Well,
yeah, he's really young, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have anything else in the vehicle that you want taken with you? House keys or anything?
Purse? You have a purse in there?
Yeah.
With a wallet?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. What color is your purse?
It's like a backpack.
Okay.
All right. There's no drug paraphernalia or anything in the purse?
No.
Because you wouldn't be able to take it with you. Okay. All right. Listen to me. I'm about to tell you something that's very important. You're under arrest for driving under the influence of an intoxicating liquor and or drug. The New Mexico Implied Consent Act requires that you submit to a breath test to determine the alcohol content of your blood. After you take our test, you have the right to choose an additional independent test. If you choose to take an additional independent test, you have the right to a reasonable opportunity to arrange for a physician, a licensed nurse, a laboratory technician, or technologist who is employed by a hospital or physician of your own choice to perform an additional chemical test. The cost of this additional test will be paid for by the law enforcement agency. Do you agree to take our test?
Yes.
I'm going to read you the whole thing just so you understand all your rights, okay?
Yes, sir.
I cannot force you to take our test or test. Take our test, but if you refuse, you will lose your New Mexico driver's license or non-resident operating privilege for 1 year. If you are convicted in court of driving under the influence, you may also receive a greater sentence because you refuse to be tested. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
One more section.
Your right to speak with an attorney or remain silent does not apply to the requirement of the New Mexico law that you take a breath test. So again, I'm going to ask you, do you agree to be tested?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do me a favor, open your mouth. I'm sorry.
You're fine.
Open your mouth, lift up your tongue. You don't have no tongue piercings or anything inside?
Nothing.
Okay.
Okay. I think that's her wallet, and then I have this little backpack here.
Okay. Put it in my front seat.
Okay, cool. Sounds good.
And again, you have no drug paraphernalia or any weapons or anything in this.
Nothing, yeah.
Empty nothing Bud Light Michelada.
Yeah.
So there's an empty Bud Light Michelada in the back seat.
Yeah.
And then that bottle of Pink Whitney vodka.
Yeah.
Okay. Like, I'll throw the machines for you.
Do you, are you IR certified?
Yes.
Can you meet me at the office when you're. 98. Thank you, sir.
Cool. I will get this knocked out.
Okay.
Gloria was arrested for driving under the influence. For more videos about criminals, hit the subscribe button.